हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द ईबीएस ऑनलाइन क्लास। आवर टुडेज टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन इज एयर। ऑल ऑफ यू नो दैट एयर इज अ मिक्सचर ऑफ गैसेस व्हिच इज फाउंड एवरीवेयर ऑन एंड अराउंड द अर्थ। वंस इट वाज सपोज्ड दैट एयर वाज अ सिंपल सब्सटेंस, बट ग्रेजुअली आवर साइंटिस्ट proved that it is a mixture of several gases. Now we have confirmed knowledge that so many gases are present above the earth combined mechanically to form a mixture of gases which is known as air. In a mixture, the components exist side by side and cannot be separated by simple mechanical methods. It is applicable for the air also. In air, there are many gases like nitrogen, oxygen, carbon dioxide, water vapor, hydrogen, carbon monoxide, ozone, argon, methane, helium, neon, krypton, xenon are present. Among these gases, helium, neon, argon, krypton, and xenon do not react with other elements. So these are known as noble gases. The proportion of nitrogen gas in the air is around 78%, whereas oxygen is present in around 20%, carbon dioxide, water vapor, and other gas are present in the proportion of 1%. The mixture of gases rests around the earth due to its gravity and forms an envelope around it. That envelope of gaseous mixture around the earth is known as atmosphere. We can say that the envelope of air surrounding the earth is called as atmosphere. The gravitational field of the earth is strong enough to prevent gases of atmosphere from escaping. This is why atmosphere of the earth remains always in a fixed position around the earth. The atmosphere around the earth is divided into a series of layers on the basis of temperature at different altitudes. Those vertical layers of atmosphere are troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere, and exosphere. Now, we will learn about these different layers one by one. First, we will discuss about troposphere. The lowest layer of atmosphere adjacent to the Earth's surface is called as troposphere. It extends up to 16 km in tropical regions and about 9.7 km in temperate regions. In this layer, temperature decreases upward at the rate of 5.5 degree per 1000 meter. The troposphere is most significant layer of atmosphere due to the following reasons. First of all, in this layer, the temperature of air decreases with increasing altitude. Secondly, the layer contains dust particles and pollutants that escape up from the earth. Up to 90% of the Earth's water vapor and clouds are found in this layer, and all the climatic and weather changes occur due to changes in this layer. Okay. Now we will learn about environmental lapse rate. The rate at which the temperature of air is decreased with the height in the atmosphere is known as environmental lapse rate. As for example, in troposphere, the temperature decreases upward at the rate of 5.5 degrees Celsius per 1000 meter. This is called as environmental lapse rate or ELR. Now we will learn about stratosphere. The layer that lies beyond troposphere is known as stratosphere. It extends up to a height of 50 kilometers. In this layer, temperature remains constant up to a height of 20 kilometers. But at an altitude of above 20 kilometers, it starts rising and continues rising up to the height of 50 kilometers. This is so because of the presence of ozone layer which absorbs ultraviolet rays of the sun. Clouds, vapor and dust are not found in this region. Now we will learn about the mesosphere. The layer of atmosphere from 50 to 90 kilometer is known as mesosphere. In this layer, temperature decreases with increasing altitude. The thermosphere is present above mesosphere. It extends from 90 to 500 kilometer or so. Temperature rises with rise in altitude in this layer. Now we will discuss about exosphere. The zone of atmosphere beyond thermosphere is known as exosphere. This zone extends up to 9600 km, which is the outer limit of the atmosphere. In the stratosphere and thermosphere, air gets warmer with the increase in altitude. Meteorologists, that means the persons who are studying with the different with the atmospheres and its changes, they are known as meteorologists. Meteorologists and space scientists say that from 80 kilometer to 1000 kilometer, there is a special zone in the atmosphere which contains ions or charged particles. It is believed that showers of electrons from the sun, ultraviolet radiations and X-rays from the space ionize many layers of atmosphere. Due to this incident, those layers start conducting electricity. Those layers also reflect radio wave back to the earth. That zone is known as ionosphere. 80 to 260 kilometer of this zone helps us to hear radio programs. In the stratosphere and thermosphere, air gets warmer with the increase in altitude. This is known as temperature inversion. It is against the principle applied in troposphere that temperature decreases with increasing altitude. The layers of atmosphere have their interface layers, which are known as tropopause. Tropopause is present between the troposphere and stratosphere. In the same way, stratopause is present at the top of the stratosphere and in between the stratosphere and mesosphere. The mesopause is present at the top of the mesosphere and in the transition place between mesosphere and thermosphere. So today, this much. In the next class, we will learn about the role of atmosphere. Thank you, children.